In this video, we're going to talk about Monero's beast of a project, Kovri, the ultimate privacy technology. But before that, you need to know why this level of privacy is important, because this goes beyond normal privacy features. You could say this is anti-CIA level untraceability, the cutting edge of internet privacy. By the way, if you want to know how Monero works, I made a beginner-friendly video explaining its internal processes in simple terms. Do check it out if you want to know why Monero is ahead of other coins in terms of privacy. As you might have likely heard from the news, a US congressman representative is calling for the ban of all cryptocurrencies. This is the beginning of a very critical moment in crypto history, since it is probably the first time that a government official truthfully admits the threat crypto brings to their establishment. In the past years, many governments shrugged Bitcoin off as something that had no chance of undermining their powers. But now, they are beginning to see the truth, and it scares the living hell out of them. This politician's name is Brad Sherman, and what's interesting to me is that he didn't use terrorism as an argument against it, which we would have expected because they've done that before. But instead, he admits that it's to preserve the power of the US government. In his own words, an awful lot of our international power stems from the fact that the dollar is the standard unit of international finance and transactions. It is the announced purpose of the supporters of cryptocurrencies to take the power away from us. Basically, he wants the US dollar to become the world reserve currency, which is absurd. Why the hell would the world want to give a single nation that kind of power? For the most part, they don't use it for good. The economic sanction they imposed on Venezuela brought the country to ruin, and the US was partly to blame for their economic crisis. Now, their national currency is technically worthless. In fact, their paper currency can be found either scattered in the streets or used to make handbags. So making the USD the reserve currency of the world is stupid. Even Americans would agree. In fact, a growing number of Americans are against a lot of things their establishment stand for. Being a crypto enthusiast for years, I stand against any politician or government that intends to impose a blanket ban on cryptocurrencies. And the fact that you are watching this video probably means you do too. So I hope this guy loses the election. He probably will. But now the words had been said, this news had made headlines, and now other governments of the world will now be more open to this idea than ever before. This is something that's always been at the back of my mind for so long. The fact that any government that sees crypto as a threat could simply outlaw it just because they fear it, not even considering the benefits it could bring to their people in the long term. China already banned ICOs, but not cryptocurrencies as a whole. The Indian government is currently assessing whether they should ban it or regulate it. The big question is, what would happen if a country completely bans the use of crypto? Can they really stop their citizens from being involved in cryptocurrencies to a large extent? Well, that depends entirely on which cryptocurrency, because this would be time for hardcore privacy coins like Monero to shine. Monero, the way it is now, is considered one of the best, if not the best, privacy coin in the world. It allows users to send and receive payments anonymously. On top of that, even the funds are concealed, allowing only the sender and receiver to know the amount. But even Monero is not completely invisible, at least not for some time. There is a potential vulnerability at the network layer. That is to say, a user's IP address can still be traced when they make a transaction, which might leak their identity. Let's say your government bans all crypto-related activities in your country. Now you might think since you're using Monero, you're safe. And you may very well be, but you'd best not be complacent. they won't be able to tell who you're sending payments to, nor can they figure out the amount. But they would be able to know, at the very least, that you're using Monero. Now, this is definitely difficult to pull off, as it will require them to constantly run many different nodes to scan the blockchain, not to mention it will be very costly. But since we're talking about governments, it would be safe to assume that they have the resources. Now, the blockchain doesn't store your IP address, but when you send a transaction, it may expose your metadata, which allow the government to confirm your identity or location through chain analysis and other extrapolation methods. And this alone could land you in jail. This concept is true for all privacy coins, but so far only Monero is working on a countermeasure, which they call Kovri. Kovri is essentially an anonymity technology that allows users to hide their internet traffic, which is a very promising solution to the problem I talked about. With Kovri around, even if governments will snoop into the blockchain network, they still couldn't prove that you use Monero at all. But how does it work? Kovri encrypts your internet traffic using Garlic encryption and Garlic routing. Basically, these things create a private overlay network which conceals a user's every move across the internet. You could think of Kovri as a condom that protects your manhood from having its data juice leak somewhere it shouldn't, and potentially from viruses too. This is beyond strong privacy. And when Kovri is implemented into Monero wallets, all transactions will be routed through the Kovri Anonymous Network, allowing Monero users to experience total internet invisibility. Unfortunately, as of this moment, Kovri is not integrated with Monero. It's still in active development, specifically in alpha phase. Doesn't mean you can't use it though. It can serve as an anonymous browser for now, similar to Tor. If you're not familiar with Tor, it's like a browser you use to access websites that are normally inaccessible via normal browsers. Mostly the deep web or darknet, whatever term you like to use. Some say the deepest secrets of the internet lie there, but I don't know, I only use anonymous browsers to watch porn. I'm from the Philippines and porn websites are blocked here. Well, at least Pornhub is. So I use Tor since I'm more familiar with it. I haven't used Kovri yet since I don't want to go through the hassle of setting it up just to bust a nut. But yeah, Kovri and Tor are basically tools for hiding your internet traffic. Tor has been around for almost 2 decades, but it has some flaws. It's not totally anonymous, at least not on the level Kovri is trying to achieve. So the purpose of this video was to raise awareness on the real essence of privacy networks. Privacy is not to aid terrorists or hide criminal activity, although those things need privacy too. But the technology itself is innocent, only the user can be good or bad. And let's admit, our governments can be bad. They've already started flexing on crypto. Don't think for a second that they'll stop there. I'm talking about all governments in general. Kovri is just one of a multitude of defenses we are preparing for ourselves, for our future. Bottom line, I think privacy is gonna become a very, very important aspect of our lives in the years to come. As all our activities and purchases get recorded, as our data becomes a commodity, as human rights violations become a normal thing, as Black Mirror becomes reality, we shall find a way to get back to sanity. Thank God for crypto, right?